So let's talk about hypogonadism.
You got it.
Did I say it right?
Hypogonadism.
Hypogonadism. And let's all learn that word together. What does it mean?
So essentially, it's low testosterone production. In other words, your body is not making enough of the male hormone.
Okay. And it also happens in women, though, right?
Absolutely. Women, although they do not have testicles, they actually produce testosterone from their ovaries and their adrenal glands.
Okay, so what's the difference between primary and central hypogonadism?
Well, you have different reasons why you can develop low testosterone, okay? This is, again, a disease of aging, a disease of other diseases. So if you have somebody who is unhealthy, let's say they have diabetes, sleep apnea, they're obese, they've taken other forms of drugs that may have affected their ability to produce testosterone, some genetic abnormalities, all of these things can lead to your body not being able to produce testosterone.
We have a list of actually some of the common symptoms of hypogonadism in men. So go ahead and take us through those, Dr. Martinez.
So think of it this way. Testosterone is the hormone that we attribute to making us look and feel like men. And so loss of body hair can be one of those symptoms, loss of muscle mass, reduce the growth of penis and or the testicles, typically the testicles that become atrophic or smaller, low or absent sex drive, fatigue, difficulty concentrating, erectile dysfunction, abnormal breast growth, also known as gynecomastia, osteoporosis or osteopenia, which is bone disease, infertility, and hot flashes are all
and
things that we can see.
Hot flashes for men too?
Absolutely.
Okay. And I've heard that too much iron in the blood can cause this problem. Is that true?
The iron, so there's certain disease processes that you can have that happen where you have a lot of iron in your blood. Typically what happens is the iron will deposit into the testicles, and that can absolutely be one of those risk factors for hypogonadism.